تمام الكرام، بعد اذنكم بس ميوت للمايك مشان الصوت. ايوه زملائي الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا بكم مجددا بلقاء جديد بموضوع مهم تحدث فيه مشاكل كثيرة، وهو البلاطات الأرضية. بدي أحكي بالإنجليزي مشان المستر سلاب. Dear colleague, welcome today with our new webinar which talk about important topic. Actually, we face many problems in this slab on a grid. Mr. Vlad Slab, he is sales manager in Piekko at Gulf countries, and he is specializing with slab on a grid solution. He will give us today this webinar and explain the problem and how we can eliminate, inshallah, the problem with the grid slab. Mr. Vlad, I will let you to share your screen and start your webinar.
Thank you very much, Mr. Abdul Hakim. Good evening, everyone. I will stop video and I will share my screen. Can you see my screen now?
Yes.
So, yes, today I want to discuss with you about free movement joint. This is joints using for industrial floors and installing between two flooring slabs. And today's discussion will be how to protect these joints. This is schedule of our presentation. We will discuss about general information about flooring, about problems which can happen with flooring during exploitation. And I will introduce Piekko flooring solution, which will show how to protect joints, which mistakes can happen. Also, I will show you some reference list of Piekko and Piekko projects in Gulf region. And also, I will show you Piekko Terra joint production. We are producing this material in UAE, in Gulf region. It means that delivery time can be very, very fast within a couple of days if this product available on stock. And I think that this point should be very important also. So this is industrial floors. And I hope that all of you already familiar with this problem, that industrial floors crushing after a couple of months of exploitation, there can happen crushing. And this is big problem for moving of any different equipment in very houses, like forklifts, like any different equipment. And of course, this flooring joints need to be repaired. And for repair of these joints, this is always costly and always it needs time. It is necessary to stop all operations in warehouses and remove all goods and start repair. And of course, all construction company interested to save this joints and prevent crushing. Also, this can save your money, and because all these charges is as extra cost. And let's discuss why this crushing can happen. Main problem that there is a very popular way is traditional way. What is the traditional way of joints? For this, many companies just installing wooden mold and casting the slab. In this case, edges of slab are not protected at all. And you can see in the right picture, this is just cold joint between two slabs. In this case, edges is not protected and after a couple of months of exploitation, already crushed. Of course, for construction company, it can save money and company can avoid extra cost. And for client also, it can be interested. But after a couple of months, client will not avoid this extra cost for repair of joint. This is standard option, dowels for transferring loads. And this round dowels should transfer loads, but there is also one problem, not only, I will show you especially the location. You can see that this is edges of slab, which is not protected. And also here you can see round dowels, which transfer loads from one slab to another slab. The problem is that this dowel can allow to move slab only in one direction, only in this horizontal direction, and not allow to moving in this direction. This is also a problem of standard solution. Another problem that always in warehouses, there is a many kind of different equipment. All of you know what is the equipment, forklifts, any kind of trolleys, and all these industrial wheels produced from very hard material, like polyurethane, polyamide, etc. And day by day, these wheels can crush these joints. Another reason of edge damages, this is a reason came from casting. Always this edge is weaker due to accumulation of cement past in this area, in these areas. It means that always this part of slab is weaker than another part of slab. And if loads will not transfer, there will be moving in vertical directions between two slabs. And day by day, as I said before, wheels of trolley will crush this part of slabs. To prevent both of this problem, to save these edges of slab and transfer loads from one slab to another slab, people using free movement joint. And this free movement joint should provide, first of all, load transfer from one slab to another slab. But this load transfer should allow moving in two horizontal directions, not only in one direction. Another thing that prefabricated joints like Terra joint, like Piekko solution, should protect edges from crushing. In this picture, you can see that edges of slab is protected by a steel plate, which is 10 by 40 mm. I will explain you a little bit later. And transferring of loads from one slab to another slab through this dowel, steel dowel. And this is round dowel. You can see this picture. Here is a round dowel, which is transferring loads from one slab to another slab. And even if joint opening will be 20 mm, this steel part will protect edges from crushing. I want to show you a present video. This is a small video which showing how this Terra joint working. And this is Terra joint which we are producing. And we, can you hear me?
Yes, Mr. Vlad.
Yeah. And this is Terra joint Piekko solution, which we are producing here and which I am introducing to you. This is two steel flat bars, which are connected with each other by plastic bolts. And during opening of this joint, this plastic bolt will be crushed. And this steel plates securing inside the slab by this anchor, you can see. And load transferring through this steel plate, through dowels. From one side of this dowel, installed plastic sleeve to prevent adhesion between this steel part and the concrete slab, and also to allow moving in two horizontal directions. Here in this picture, you can see dowels. This is dowels, sleeve, two flat bars, and the anchors, which securing this flat bars inside the concrete slab. These flat bars protecting these edges from crushing. And little bit about theory. Why this joint is opening? This is very often engineers asking why this joint open. This is due to shrinkage of slab. As you know, after casting, slab will change the size. And normally it should be approximately like 1 mm per 1 linear meter of slab. It means that if slab will be approximately 30 by 30 meters, opening will be approximately, shrinkage of this slab will be approximately 30 mm. But it can be more, it can be less, it depends from size of slab, it depends from thickness of slab, it depends from concrete grade. We are speaking about opening of terra joints up to 20 mm. At this picture, you can see that terra joint allow opening in two horizontal directions. After shrinkage, in this horizontal direction, and due to some forces inside concrete in this horizontal direction along the joint. And regarding maximum size slab, if slab will be jointless, it can be 30 by 30 meters. This is maximum size. If it will be bigger, like 50 by 50, it should be already with saw-cutted joints. Size, which we are producing from 90 mm height of joint to 245 mm, 245 millimeters. It means that normally it should be used for slab thickness from 100 mm to 250 mm. For connection of joints, we can propose X junction and also T junctions. A few words regarding material and areas where terra joints can be used. Terra joint can be produced from normally producing from black steel. Terra joint top rails and dowels, black steel. For some cases, if terra joint will be used outside of warehouses, it can be hot dip galvanized. Of course, hot dip galvanizing can protect and joints can work outside, but it cannot protect, cannot give full protection from water. If you need more protection, we can provide terra joints with the stainless steel top rails, only with the stainless steel top rails. If you need more protection, for example, it will be areas where will be some acid or something like that, we can provide terra joint with top rails, which will be produced from 314 steel, stainless steel grade. And also all parts inside, like divider plate and plate dowels, will be also produced from stainless steel. This is depends from client's needs. Also, we can produce a Terra joint, which we calling pre-opened. It means that between these two parts, two flat bars, will be pre-installed foam. Foam can be different, can be 5 mm, 10 mm, 15 mm, and depends from needs. We can calculate which exactly thickness of foam client need. But it's in many cases when casting during winter time, there is some risks that after the casting, slab in high temperatures during summertime, for example, can start increase the size, can change the size and can start be bigger. In this case, there should be foam between these two slabs. For installing of Terra joints, we are recommending to use a special fixing device instead of rebar pins. This fixing device can secure Terra joint in correct position. And this is a very fast releasing. And this is a very fast releasing of this installing device after casting. And it is no needed to use special pins, rebar pins. Another very important question, what will be the visible parts of Terra joint after casting? At this picture, you can see it will be visible parts. Only two steel plates, and the width of this steel plates is 10 mm. 10 mm plus 10 mm, and between of these two steel plates will be opening. And normally we are recommending sealing, rubber sealing, between two of these parts. At this picture, you can see connection of two Terra joint elements, how it should be connected with each other. As I said before, these two parts connected by plastic bolts, and always for connection of two elements, each element is 3 meters length. For connecting of these two elements, we are providing special plastic bolts and wing nuts. And at site, workers can install Terra joint and connect it with each other by these plastic bolts and wing nut. Also, for securing, people can use rebars. This is just a pin, and this pin securing Terra joint and in proper position. This is also visible part from another project. And the many, very often engineers asking how it will looks, because if it's black steel, how it will looks during exploitation. But I can say that during exploitation, there will be moving of different kind of equipment, like trolleys, like forklifts, and these steel parts will be always polishing. And always these steel parts will look like at this picture. It will be polished. There will be no rusting. I will show you one video, and there will be some parts from our production and from casting. So regarding calculations, at this video, there was some pictures from office with engineers who can calculate terra joints as per as client's needs. And here is a link. This is Piekko software, which we call Piekko Designer. And one of part of this Piekko Designer, especially designed for flooring joint, for calculations of for flooring joints. And all of you can install this software, just download it from our web page. I can send, I can share with you this presentation with this link. And calculations as per as TR34 rules, and it is necessary to put all data, size of slab, loads, and as a result, you can get which size, which thickness of dowels you need for transfer loads. Also, we can show you how to calculate, or we can collect all data. You can just share with us drawings, and we can calculate, our engineers can calculate and give you a final offer with needed thickness of dowels, which will transfer loads. Top rails, top part of terra joint always will be same. It will be 10 by 40 mm. And also, this is our new product, which we calling Piekko Wavered Joint. As you can see, this is same as sinus joint, cosinus joint. This is wavered joint. Principally, it's approximately the same as terra joint. There is dowels for transferring loads and top rails, but this top rails is wavered. For which purpose using these wavered joints? This wavered joints especially designed for splitting loads. When some forklifts or some trolleys, heavy forklifts crossing joints between two slabs, especially thanks to this wavered joints, there is a splitting of loads and not strong hitting at the edges of slab. It means that this wavered joints protecting edges is more efficient. For some cases, some client, I know it, especially in Saudi Arabia, very interesting about this joint. And I'm sure that this product also can be interesting. And even more, we are discussing today about terra joint, but this is wavered joint. I saw many times combination of both of these solutions at site, at projects, and company using both of these in and special, how to say, heavy traffic areas should be installed wavered joint. But in all other areas in the warehouses can be installed terra joint. This is like just a solution which also can be used. Few words regarding reference of projects with the terra joints in Saudi market and in UAE market. And you can see a Lulu distribution center in Dammam. This project was approximately 4 years ago. And some projects in UAE. This is one of one of last project here also in UAE, in Abu Dhabi. And this at this picture, you can see installing of terra joint before casting and after casting. At this picture, you can see how to secure terra joint without special devices, only by this rebar pins. And this at this picture, you can see slab after casting. this is just for understanding that this terra joint can work instead of mold, instead of wooden mold, like in case with the standard solution. This is joint after opening, after a couple of days after casting. And this joint will continue open within a couple of weeks. This is normal processes which are going inside of concrete. After a couple of days, it will open maybe for 2 or 3 mm. But after maybe 2 or 3 weeks, it will open only for 8 or 10 mm. And it is very important to know to avoid sealing with the rubber immediately after casting, because this joint will continue open. I will show you later some mistakes during casting. This is also one of projects in UAE, but like idea, it should be also interesting for clients. Why I put this picture in my presentation? Here is a two different types of building. Foundation should be connected with slab on grade. And it is necessary to protect edges of foundation. But the problem that slab on grade will be casted later, after a couple of months. For that, we can supply separately, just top rails, separately sleeves, and separately dowels. At this picture, you can see already installed one part of top rail. To prevent from rusting, this part galvanized. You can see this color, this is hot dip galvanized. And this sleeves secure it to the mold. This is also like one of ideas which can be used for some of projects. This is standard option, standard terra joint, always installing like this by pins. But for increasing of anchorage capacity, client asked to install rebars along terra joint. This is a picture from site, and you can see this is normal industrial floors. This is also a visible part of terra joint. I put many pictures with this visible parts because very often clients asking how it will be, how it will look after casting, and it will look like this. And I would say this is practically invisible, only some parts, 10 mm plus 10 mm plus opening, which can be average size of opening approximately 8 to 10 mm. This is non-standard junctions. For connecting of terra joint, we are proposing junctions. But normally standard junctions should be without dowels. But for some cases, we can propose junctions with dowels to reduce distance between two dowels. Normally, this is for heavy loads and to prevent situations that distance between two dowels will be higher than needed. It should be approximately 40 centimeters. Now I want to show you problems which can happen with terra joints due to some mistakes. I think it's also very important to discuss it now that this mistakes is possible. And what is the problem? As I said earlier, terra joints can be black, can be hot dip galvanized, and can be stainless steel top rails. For areas which located outside, of course, necessary install protected terra joint like hot dip galvanized or stainless steel. In this case, we did not discuss it with client. Client was sure that there will be no water, but this condensation from roof and this area was always underwater. As a result, terra joints got rusted. Of course, it is necessary to brush and protect by paint, because during exploitation, here will be installed roof, and it will, this area will be protected from water. But during casting, during this mounting period, it is necessary to protect terra joints, and of course necessary to use something like galvanized joints. Here at this picture, you can see that also X junction, and at this area installed pin connector, pin for securing of terra joint. And this pin installed in this area in corner of slab. And this pin also is a problem for opening of joint. As a result, on this right picture, you can see this cracking, which happens in the corner, at the corner of slab, because inside was installed this pin. And this is very important. This is not needed to install pin very close to corner. It should be no any problem for opening, because we, especially for that, to prevent any problem, we are supplying our terra joints with the plastic balls. There should be no any big problem for opening. And this is ceiling. And normally, as I said before, better to make ceiling after a couple of weeks. At this picture, you can see that client put this rubber ceiling inside the terra joint after a couple of days after casting. But after a couple of weeks, this joint continue opening. And you can see at this picture problem, which already happens with this rubber ceiling. And of course, it is necessary remove all the ceiling from here and make it again, to make repair needed. And it was necessary to wait a couple of weeks and only after that make casting. Of course, we are giving all these recommendations for clients. So a few words about our factory, which located in Ras Al Khaimah in UAE. This is new factory, which was open only 2020 in February. And we are producing full range of Piekko items here, and of course, terra joints. This is production equipment for terra joints. This is top rails, already prefabricated top rails. There was mentioned in my presentation, this is cold rolled steel. And this is anchors. We have special gun machine for welding of this anchors. And this is assembling of terra joints, assembling tables. And also you can see this is non-standard items, which we are producing for one of clients. And we installed this special rebars, because thickness of slab is higher than 250 mm. This is also assembling. This green color is dowels. And it can be green colors and can be gray colors. And different that for 6 mm dowels, we're using green color dowels, sleeves. And for 8 mm dowels, we're using gray color sleeves. This is just to recognize what is the size, what is the thickness of dowel. This is packaging. Normally we are loading 30 pieces of terra joints per one pallet. And this is storage area. And this is approximately for one truck. And we can load approximately 1 kilometer of terra joints per one truck. And this quantity, I would say that is most popular volume, which our clients need for some not very big warehouses. Approximately 1 kilometer of terra joints per one truck. So, and that's it. And I would ask you If you have any questions, please ask me. I can repeat whatever you want. I can explain more, and I can add and show some more pictures.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Flynn. Thank you very much for this presentation. And please, colleague, the question will be by raised hand, and we'll give the mic by Terry. If there is any question.
Yes, I can see now one question. How we can protect terra joint which is not galvanized? This is a correct question. How to protect? Of course, it is possible to protect by primer, by painting, but we should understand how long it will work. Painting primer can protect only for a couple of weeks because this is not enough thickness of painting. But we can, if we are discussing only to protect for not very long time, we can propose this option.
Good.
And what is a good idea for the cost per square meter of slab on grade? I think it's regarding increasing compared with standard option. It depends from slab thickness, but we calculated already it approximately will be approximately 10 reals per square meters. This is very, very average. It is necessary to calculate, especially for the project. After getting some technical data, drawings, we can calculate and we can give more details. But approximately, it will be like 10 reals per square meter.
The continue of the question, Mr. Vlad, what we will fill the gap?
Yeah, as I understood, how fill the gap? And this is a gap, yes, between two these steel parts. By any kind of rubber. And this is not a Piekko scope of work, but we have, I think, many companies can provide this sealing and recommendations how to fill this rubber inside of this opening. From our side, we can give recommendation that it is necessary to make as later as possible after a couple of weeks to avoid this problem, which I show you on a couple of pictures before. Yeah, how many projects were done in UAE? Yeah. The other applications, and yes.
Can you on your video come, please, Mr. Vlad?
One second. Which video you mean?
Your cam.
Sorry, I can't hear you, Mr. Abdul Hakim.
Sorry. Your camera.
Yeah.
The mic was closed, my mind. Sorry. So when we will see you,
one second. Communication. Yeah, it will be easy. Now you can see my face. Yeah.
Okay.
Hello. Yes. And how many projects were done in UAE? I would say that I cannot say you exactly how many projects, but I think that totally in UAE and in Saudi, it was already more than 100.
Good.
Because we located in Middle East already more than 10 years. And terra joints, this is quite old product. And this is necessary to calculate exactly, but in my personal knowledge, it's more than 100.
Good.
Together.
Mr. Vlad, there is one question I noticed through your presentation. There is a grade slab 30 by 30 without joint.
Yes, jointless. Joint slab.
Yes.
Yeah.
We can go up to this distance without or any joint?
Yes. 30 by 30 is possible without any cutting joints inside of this slab. But it depends from experience of company who will make. And it also depends from their equipment. Okay. If they can make it, of course they can make and they can proceed with Terra joints. But very often I saw many projects with 25 by 25 slabs here.
Okay, thank you.
Here is one more question. Is there is any other application than industrial facilities? Yes, it can be, but not only industrial, as I said, warehouses, but also I know that in hypermarkets, it's possible. And I would say that it can be any areas which, in which needed to protect these edges from crushing, because this is a main problem. If there is any forklifts or some trolleys can move and can crush these joints, in this case, we can propose these Terra joints.
Okay, let me give now the question to Mr. Riz Hajawi. Tafadhal Ustazna.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum assalam.
Thanks for this presentation. I want to ask about the thickness of expansion joint inside. Is it different to make it in summer or in winter for in construction? The same width if we do it in summer or winter at site?
And I think that you mean thickness of foam inside. This
not the thickness, according to the width of expansion joint, suppose we calculate it 2.5 centimeters. If we make this construction in winter,
yes,
you will do it 2.5, and the same thing if we constructed that in the summer, the same thing, 2.5, or we should take the client at this time of construction.
It can be to prevent situation when this slab can be bigger after casting. As I know, this situation can happen if generally we are speaking about temperature difference between circumstances when you make in casting, for example, winter time, and temperature during exploitation. If this temperature difference is quite high, depends of this temperature difference, we can calculate and give you recommendation. Should be this joint pre-opened or not? Because as I know that during summertime, if you will make casting during summertime, it's not needed because you make in casting under hot temperature. But if you will make casting during winter time, of course, it is necessary to think about it. And this pre-opening can be 10 or 15 mm, and also depends from size of slab.
Okay, thanks.
There is one question, Mr. Vlad said, is there any manual or papers for more detailing about this Terra joint?
Sorry?
If there
is any software, I can see this.
More detail about this Terra joint.
Yes, of course. All information you can find in our web page, and there is a technical manual. And you can find all information. And in any case, you can send me some inquiry. I will send you even drawings.
Thank you.
To put these drawings at your drawings, just a model of Terra joint, which you can put at your drawings. Here I can see one more question. Is the software can calculate the slab on grade thickness or only calculation and design Terra joint? Yes, this is for calculations only. Our scope of work only not full Terra joint. When we are speaking Terra joint, we means dowels for transferring loads. This is only for our scope of work.
There is one question also. What is the cost impact between using Terra joint or maybe the damage will happen in the future or occur in the future?
This is a very interesting question. Yes. As I said, that Terra joint increasing costs approximately, let's say 10 reals per square meters. But regarding loads, if there will be no terra joints, if there will be standard joints, the problem with these joints and loads, which can generate this problem, this is depends from project to project. But as I know, for example, we discussed with IKEA, IKEA hypermarkets, this furniture hypermarkets, we discussed with them. As per their calculations, it was much more cheaper to install terra joints in the beginning. Then, you know, this is furniture. You cannot just cover it by tape. It is necessary to remove all materials from these areas and to close these areas for visitors. And of course, this is quite costly. It, not only for one day, it's a couple of days, maybe even 1 week, to close this IKEA hypermarket for visitors, to remove all goods from this area, to remove all concrete and to make new joints. Of course, it's quite costly and this is very difficult to calculate. But agreed. Agreed.
Actually, for big damage for this joint, but small damage, I think I can repair it yearly with small amount instead of using this terra joint.
Yes, this is, we did not discuss in my presentation, but how it normally looks. There is a problem in one joint between two slabs. How people make in repair? They just cutting these areas, to removing concrete from one area and filling with concrete. And they're getting two joints. And there will be, after a couple of months, they will make repair again. And then it is necessary to calculate all together, not only one repair. And this is necessary to calculate how many repairs will be within 1 or 2 years. And I can send even picture from our very houses, and factory opening was already more than 1.5 years ago. And there is installed terra joints, and factory working and terra joints also working very well.
Very nice. Actually, Mr. Vlad, the main problem actually you are facing in this great slab, it is the cracks.
Yes.
And this is good solution actually for the joint. But from your work using this terra joint, is there any fix on the crack?
Now, between steel part and concrete?
No. Surface crack actually.
Surface cracking can happen. It's terra joint.
You cannot avoid it.
This is not question already to pick a product. It depends from experience of companies, and then we responsible for this part, for terra joints and for securing terra joint itself in concrete slab. But of course, if company who making floors are professionals, of course there will be no any cracking inside the slab. But terra joints cannot prevent all this cracking, and we are not responsible for quality of all floors. So this is not like idea to prevent all problems. No, this is idea only to prevent crashing of these edges.
Edges, exactly.
Yeah.
This is and good here is one, for this.
Yeah, here is one more question regarding, there was, one second, regarding hot dip galvanizing.
Is there a cost comparison between galvanized steel and stainless steel? Does it require skilled labor? Two questions.
Yeah. One second. Regarding hot dip galvanized, there is no cost comparison. This is we have price list and but the price different is quite big. This is depends also from size of slab. Always price depends from height of joint. But there is not very big difference between black and hot dip galvanized steel, but quite big, maybe in even 3-4 times between black and stainless steel.
Okay, there is one question in Arabic. What is the time life of this terra joint? How long it will live? 10 years, for example?
It depends from how intensive will be traffic, what is the slab of thickness, and in my personal feeling that and knowledge also, as I know, this is terra joint life period is not limited. I think that flooring life is limited, and there will be crushing inside this slab. I mean that some parts around the columns, and there will be a lot of crushing already, cracking inside this slab. Not regard this question, not regarding terra joints, because we are responsible, we are providing warranty for terra joints, but this is only regarding securing terra joint inside the concrete and regarding transferring of loads from one slab to another slab. And in these areas, normally should be no any problem, because this 10 mm plates securing inside this concrete slab by this 10 mm diameters anchors, and this is enough to secure it very stable. Okay. And here is one more question I can see.
I will continue. There is the rest of question in Arabic. The question is, this terra joint can be used in the bridge?
I will say no, because this is quite small. As I depends from what we mean bridge.
Where we have to use it actually.
This is not for terms. At least this is not for mainly not for open areas, even not for outside areas. It should be protected, as I said, for outside areas. But for bridge, I will say no. This is a little bit different product.
ما بنستخدمها معناتها يا استاذ محمد بالنسبه للجسور. طيب, there is a question. This is, I think, from Mr. Muhammad. Is terra joint can be for any slab on a grade thickness, or it is available for a few thickness?
Yes, it can be for any. This is there was one page, one slide in my presentation, and there was mentioned that slab thickness from 100, even I said that from 100 to 250 mm. But honestly, it can be different. It can be, yes, this is correct, that 100 mm slab thickness, like minimum size, but maximum size can be different. We can make it up to 400 mm if it needed. This is just necessary to install dowels for transferring loads. Always should be approximately in the middle part of this slab. This is one important thing. And also, there was like grade 90 mm, 115 mm, 135 mm, 160. But if it needed, of course, we can produce any size. For example, it can be 175 or something like that. Any size we can produce. But in many cases it's not needed, because in any case, there should be a gap between terra joint and ground, something like 15 mm. Approximately, it can be 10 mm, it can be 20, it depends from size of slab. And normally our standard range of product is enough to provide all this range.
Okay, this terra joint, it can be used or can take heavy loads?
Yes, it can take heavy loads, and mainly these heavy loads transferring by these dowels. As I said, it can be up to 12 mm. And if it needed, we can install more dowels. And this also we can calculate. But this top part of terra joint, this top rails, always will be same, 10 by 40 mm. But this top part doesn't work for transferring loads. But for heavy loads, yes, we can provide 12 mm dowels.
But yeah.
There was one more question. Looks like we missed it. Does it require skilled labor? I would say for installing of terra joints, not. It's as we discussed, company should have experience with the flooring. But to install terra joints, no, it's not needed. It's quite simple, and we have recommendation in our technical manual. There is a recommendation how to install how to secure terra joints, and for that no needed skilled labor.
Good. Any question? Zumbalana, any question? Zumbalana.
I think that Mr. Abdul Hakim, you can send my email for everyone. If anyone have any questions, I can send a link to download our technical manual, and of course I will reply. If you have more questions, I will reply.
Yeah, we have one question from Mr. Karam Somi. Mr. Karam, please proceed with your question. Mr. Karam.
One second, I will reply on one more question. Time issue, any comparison between terra joint and traditional? No, there is only time for installing of, in any case, both traditional and terra joint, both of these ways, it is necessary to install in traditional way, it is necessary to install mold. In terra joint, also necessary to install terra joints. And I will say that time for installing approximately same. And time for casting, exactly same. And after 1 day, you will make this polishing. I think approximately this time same for traditional and for terra joints.
Okay. Mr. Karam.
Sorry, it was added by mistake. Sorry for that.
Yeah, no question, huh?
No question. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. أي سؤال زملائنا؟ راح نأخذ آخر سؤال لأنها يسترنا شي ساعة. أبدا ساعة بالضبط. I think we received one more. Installation by main contractor and what role of Piekko?
Piekko is a supplier of terra joint. Yeah, and so, also as I said before, we have technical team. We have.
You can advise contractor.
Yes. We can give recommendation. We can calculate which size of terra joints necessary to install. We can generate ideas together with client. Maybe it should be pre-opened or it should be painted, or maybe they need some non-standard terra joint, and we can provide these solutions. But regarding main contractor from site point of view, we are just supplier.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Zumbalana. سؤال أخير. إذا في سؤال رح نأخذ آخر سؤال. Last question. أعتقد مضى الأسئلة. I think there is no more question. Mr. Vlad, really I thank you for this presentation and solution for the joint, and hope inshallah to meet you in next webinar with some other solution for great slab from Piekko.
Thank you. So, thank you very much. Please share my contacts with all participants, and also if someone want to see what is samples, we can provide also sample, because I know that it is necessary to show in some projects, it is necessary to show to client what we calling terra joint, what is this, it is necessary touched, and we can provide sample if it needed, just let me know. We will provide this sample in Saudi Arabia. It's no issue.
Thank you. We will upload this presentation on our YouTube channel and also the group, and we will share all your detail and any other detail from Piekko also.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day. Thank you for your time. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.